Hey, my friends, welcome back here. This is Simple Italian Cooking. You know, the place where we do easy and quality food at home. So today we will do a very, very rich pasta dish from Southern Italy. Have a look. You got it right. So this is called spaghetti alla puttanesca. And I'm not going to translate this right now, but I think the name comes from the fact that the sugo is very open to many, many different ingredients. And so let's have a look what kind of ingredients these are. So we of course have our main pillars of a tomato sugo, which is of course olive oil, let's say half piece of red onion, a little bit of garlic, basil, and certainly the tomato polpa. But in addition to that, we have a few more ingredients that make it a real puttanesca. So this is, for example, starting with those few ugly olives that we will cut in small pieces, a salvia leaf, a bunch of parsley, some chili. We have this moderately spicy pepper and this spicy chili. And then very important, we will add these capers, and we will also add these anchovies. We will also add a little bit of oregano. Not sure if you can see, have a look. I filled this glass with oregano. A little bit of pepper, black salt, and that's it. And very important, we will not add any parmigiano, because as you know, fish and cheese is a deadly mix. So no parmigiano, but anything else goes, which makes it a real puttanesca. And now my coffee is ready. Okay, my friends, we will now start with the cutting work. By the way, I forgot to mention, of course, when we do spaghetti, we will also need spaghetti. So calculate 100 grams per person as a portion, as a reasonable portion. If you're hungry, if you're a construction worker, maybe also 200 grams. And yeah, so we'll start cutting the onions. So as I said, you don't need a full onion, half onion will absolutely be enough. And so this is what I'm cutting. Of course, half an onion, depending on the onion size. So we got onion. What else do we need? We will need olive oil. There we go. We will need salvia leaf at the beginning, because this also needs to fry a little bit. We will need some garlic, so I cut this garlic piece in small pieces. Perhaps we can even cut two garlic pieces. And we will certainly need a little bit of chili. This is not too spicy, it's already a bit dry, as you see, so it's good for the flavor, but it will not be too spicy, so that's okay to add. And I will also cut these olives from the season, because I'm afraid that the children will bite on them. They are not that big, so it's better to cut them. And I will keep doing so, and I think we can also do a cut now. And I see you in a few seconds once they are. Okay, my friends, after two olives, I gave up, so I just throw them inside. And we will now add the anchovies. The more the better. They will all melt while the olive oil gets heated up, so it's not a problem if they are now sticking together. You will see in a few minutes it's all done, it's all melted. And once the anchovies, oh, by the way, yes, we also want to. There we go. My fingers were a bit oily from the anchovies, so we will also add some of these capers. That's enough. Let this fry for a few minutes, and then we will add the tomatoes. Okay, you see, the anchovies have almost melted. It's now the time to open the polpa, which we will now add on top. add this basil that I cut already, a little bit of parsley, the remaining parsley we'll add at the end. And we got oregano. As you know, it's a puttanesca, so anything goes. Anything is welcome. Let's see if we got some pepper left. A little. We got salt. Hopla! This is too much. This is okay. And, ah yes, we got our black salt from Cyprus. What else we got? Oh, yes. We got a beer. I now deserve a beer after a hard working day. And I will see you in a few minutes. Okay, so you see the puttanesca sugo is now enjoying the mix of the different flavors. It's now all cooking together. And we will let this cook now at low flame, let's say at 4 or 3. 3 is also okay. I will even close. And after 30 minutes, we will throw in the spaghetti and then we are ready to eat. Okay, my friends, let's have a look how we are doing. Spaghetti, I would say 3-4 more minutes until they are al dente. Actually, we need them 1 minute before al dente, because the final minute we will cook them right here. So let's see how our puttanesca is doing. Oh yes, she is enjoying all these different ingredients and it has a really, really nice smell. Yes. Okay, I think we are finally there. I need to do a very final quality check. Let's see. Yeah. This tastes like puttanesca. Yeah. Okay, we are 1 minute before al dente, and so this is the time now to throw in the spaghetti and mix them up well. Really puttanesca. Listen to the sound. Okay, my friends, I hope you enjoyed this video. You see down there, there is this subscribe button. Feel free to click on it, because I will produce many, many more videos similar to this. And so I just say buon appetito. Let's enjoy this puttanesca. Wow. Oh. Mm. That was too small. Let's get a bigger one.